We now read from Isaiah chapter 40. And I'd like to begin with verse 21 this morning rather than later in the chapter. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is He who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to live in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth pass nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth, when He blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like a stone. To whom then will you compare me? Or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these. He who brings out their hosts and numbers them, calling them by name, because He is great in strength, mighty in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, thy way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And then finally, our scripture for the gospel lesson comes from Mark chapter 1, beginning verse 29. Referring to Jesus and those who were following Him, some of whom would become His disciples, we read, as soon as they left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew, along with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law, you might recall Simon was also named Peter. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve him. That evening at sundown, they brought to Him all who were sick or possessed with demons, and the whole city was gathered around the door. And He cured many who were sick with various diseases, cast out many demons, and He would not permit the demons to speak, because they knew Him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, He got up and went out to a deserted place, and there He prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for Him. When they found Him, they said to Him,